Roussel. You were elected CEO of the Global Solar Council in August 2017, fairly new. And before her, you were head of public affairs of Trina, which is a Chinese PV manufacturer. I think all in all, you have worked 15 years in the solar thermal industry in different continents. So what is the objectives of this Global Solar Council?
The Global Solar Council is the international body of the national associations as well as the leading corporations in the world. Our objective is to enable solar energy to deliver on its potential, both for economic development, for clean power, and for opportunity around the world.
What do you mean by solar power? Is it solar thermal, solar PV, solar concentrating?
Solar power can include PV technologies, solar thermal technologies, as well as storage technologies and the digital energy solutions that solar energy enables.
We have seen PV markets exploding. Do you still have anything to lobby for?
For sure we do. Unfortunately, many of the markets in the world today are still driven by government policies, and those are the lucky markets, the markets where enabling policy has been put in place. But unfortunately, the market dynamics are still dependent upon those incentives or specific enabling infrastructure. In more than half of the world's markets, we do not have a solar market today. And the reason for that is, even though that solar is now cost competitive, we don't have an enabling regulatory framework, an administrative framework, or the necessary incentives to encourage entrepreneurs to take a look at solar energy. So in the longer term, lobbying for better regulatory frameworks and legal frameworks for solar energy is absolutely critical.
So the news that we have feed-in tariffs in more than 100 countries worldwide, is this a fake news?
It's certainly not fake news, but I think the challenge is that if we look at where are the 20 largest markets, we have three or four countries, China, the United States, India, and others, that are by far leading the global market. And they produce the greatest share of volume in the entire market today. So our challenge is, how do we bring up those other markets from market number 5 to market number 20 to be multi-gigawatt markets above 5 gigawatts a year, providing a stable business environment and stable demand for domestic entrepreneurs? From there, we can look at the remaining 160 countries and how do we move them from a few megawatts a year to several gigawatts, enabling solar to really deliver on its promise.
China is an interesting issue because at the moment they are eating so much of the PV modules themselves that they produce, so there might be again a bottleneck on the market.
So I think that that's true. Many people are talking about the demand crunch that's happening right now. China is today very quickly, it's become 50% of the global market. And with the market at approximately 45 gigawatts this year, we'll still wait on the final numbers in December and January. We see a challenge, whereas in next year, if demand isn't as strong in China, we may have a swing to a situation where there's oversupply. And balancing this is a very challenging policy task, and it's not an easy one, as the market for solar energy, driven by, let's say, a robust enabling environment in China, as well as by regular citizens being very concerned about air pollution and people wanting to go solar because it's cost effective, driving a very healthy domestic market.
Wow. I wish you good luck for your work.
Thank you, Barbara.